friends. In this video, we are going to solve a problem on finding the transfer function of a system. So this is the question, and we have to find out the transfer function of the system. The circuit is given to us. So this is the current flowing in the circuit, that is IT. So for finding the transfer function, first determine that what is your input and what is your output. In this, we have VIT, it is the input. And VOT, that is, it is the output. So let's solve it. We know that the Kirchhoff's voltage law, it says that in a loop, the sum of the voltages, the algebraic sum of the voltages, it is equal to zero. So let's apply the KVL in this first loop. We have VIT as the input voltage. And this input voltage will be equal to the voltage drop across the resistance will be R IT plus the voltage drop across the capacitor will be 1 by C integration of IT dt. So this is the KVL equation which we have obtained by applying it in the loop. Now, if we apply the KVL in this second loop, then just V0t, it will be equal to the voltage drop across the capacitor. So V0t, it will be equal to 1 by C integration IT dt. So these are the two equations which we have obtained. Now take Laplace transform on both sides of these two equations. We will get first apply it on the first equation. The Laplace transform of VIT will be VIS Laplace transform of R IT will be IS plus 1 upon C integration IT dt. So its Laplace transform will be 1 upon S IS. Now taking Laplace transform of second equation. Laplace transform of V0t will be V0s. And Laplace transform of 1 upon C integration IT dt will be 1 upon SC IS. So these are the two equations which we have obtained after applying the Laplace transform. Now from the first equation, If we get the value of IS, it will be 1 + 1 = 0. In this we have IS, we can take it as common. So R plus 1/SC and IS is taken as common. V0S we have already obtained that it is 1/SC IS. Now we have to take, we have VIS is our input voltage and V0S is our output voltage. So we have to take the ratio of the Laplace transform of the output and the input. That is the transfer function. So transfer function will be ratio of V0S and VIS. So putting the values of V0S and VIS in the numerator and the denominator, we have both IS and IS, so they will be cancelled out. So the value of V naught by VIS will be 1/SC. Here we have 1 + SCR by SC. This SC and SC will be cancelled out. So we will get 1/1 + SCR. So the transfer function will be (1/1 + SCR). This CR, it is also known as T, that is the time constant of the system. So in some cases, you can also represent this transfer function as 1/1 + ST. T is the time constant. So in this way, you can find out the transfer function of a system. Hope you have understood it. Thank you.